Right. E-commerce application, we will discuss the learning outcome 5. Be able to create an online, be able to create an e-commerce site using e-commerce applications. The indicative contents are create an online presence, the feedback, the present solution. So let us discuss, we are discussing all these indicative contents one by one. Create online presence. So defining an organization's e-commerce offerings. So when you are running a business, there is always something more that you feel you should, you could be done. So it's always important that you should put your efforts more and more in order to create your online presence. Number one is the brand ambassadors. Depending on your demographic, brand ambassadors, mostly a celebrity, may be a great way to rise up your sales. Ambassadors are a great way to expand your reach in different regions and to have real people sharing your brand instead of advertising. So the presence of your business needs to be increased by the use of brand ambassadors. Brand ambassadors is basically a concept that you try to hire a celebrity that will be marketing your product, and then it will get a more attraction towards customers. Provide live chat. So basically we are discussing the online presence, that how you are present online, how well you are present. When customers are on your site, you don't want anyone to hesitate about clicking purchase. Having a live chat option allows any questions or concerns to be addressed immediately, so visitors are more likely to buy. So second option, that you need to provide the online chat so that every active customer should not go away. So that's also the second strategy to make your presence active. Referral programs, defining an organization's essence offerings. So how you can offer? You can offer the referral program. Customers will listen more to what their friends tell them to buy than what an ad says. So referral programs are basically your website being marketed, advertised by the friends. If you are trying to, let's say, refer the particular website to your friend using email, using Facebook, or possibly certain APIs, the application programming interfaces are used. What happens when you send them a link of a particular product? Then within the link, your referral name, your ID is also included, and whatever they purchase, the commission goes to you, to your account automatically, or whoever is referring. Then by the affiliate kind of program, the referral program, it increases the sales. The normal customers rely trust to their friends and known referrals. Social media customer service. As your company grows and social media accounts become larger, it can be hard to keep up with the comments and questions posted. However, when you manage, when you engage with your customers publicly, you not only answer their questions but show your dedication to your company and build an element of trust with customers. So nowadays, all the companies which are selling online, they have also an strong base of social media platform. They not only respond to the customers via their website, but they are supposed to answer every questions on the social media platforms. And people nowadays, they mostly communicate to everyone via social media accounts. For example, if you have a query and you are unable to ask anyone, then quickly you need to go certain page of a particular website, and it is your responsibility of the owner of the e-commerce site that you should respond it clearly, openly, and quickly. Product suggestions: once customers have already purchased from you and hopefully had a wonderful experience, they are more likely to purchase again from you than from a company they haven't purchased from yet. So it's important to give them a catered suggestions for their next purchase. Inform them of new releases and make it easy for them to come back and purchase again. So product suggestions in terms of online, offline, or marketing by email to the existing customers about their new catalogs, any offers, is much more helpful in order to increase the presence of your store. Identifying target audience for e-commerce solutions. You have to identify the target audience. Here are 6 ways to determine the target audience for your e-commerce store. First is know your audience. Audience in the e-commerce industry works differently from total of real world. So the audience are your customers are basically dealt differently than the normal customers you have in your store. How merchants don't interact with customers via customers as they would at physical store. Obviously, in the online store, you will not be meeting your customers like in the normal stores. You could talk to them, you could say to them hello, hi, or maybe you could tell them anything in any way of the marketing, let's say handing them the particular brochures, any gifts, small gifts, or anything could be offered to them, but it is different from the online store. Hence, judgment on one's behavior and personality varies at almost every encounter. So you cannot judge that how the customer is, whether it's a good customer, whether the customer will buy more of the items online or not. Because in the normal store, probably you could attract them by your word, but on the internet, it's a little bit. Let's say you have an online store for sports wear. Now it is important that you understand the lifestyle and behavior of people who follow sports on a regular pattern. It would be easier if you yourself are a fan of what you are selling. So it is important, whatever you are selling, you should have some knowledge about your product. This act removes the need for carrying out basic research, as you already know what, how, and when your potential customer wants your product. So you need to search that, you need to research indeed that how, what, and when your potential customers need any product and what kind of thing they are looking for. So all you need to know your audience online. Picture your potential customer as an e-com store, or for example, sportswear. You should have an understanding of your target market, that what is in the market, what should be in the market. This step be carried out by making an individual profile for every user that visits your online store. Once determined who you have to focus on, your marketing decisions will become much easier. You will be able to selectively target a group of similar customer profiles. For example, the products that you have available and products might be differentiated according to the nature of customers, according to the age of customers, according to the gender of customers. So you should be able to create a picture of your potential customer, that who is your customer and what he or she really needs. You need to understand and you need to market accordingly. Customer segmentation. Now that you have created customer profiles, it is best advice to categorize your target audience. You need to categorize your audience according to their preferences, maybe age, maybe gender, the same thing. make use of demographical information such as name, address, user behavior, etc. So the demographic information is also important, that from which area the customer is coming. In fact, modern practices suggest that business should make note of customers' lifestyle, profession, needs that are not being met. So profession is also the one concern that you need to consider in classifying your customers. For example, your store might be dealing with the people who work, and might be the items, there might be the items who do not work or may not come in that particular category, or maybe they could be classified according to different type of nature of the work. Helps online stores to better cater users as well as rightly mold promotional messages. So promotional messages, promotion, everything, if you have a segmentation of your customers, then it is much more helpful for you to suggest them about your store products. Surveys and customer feedback. Many successful entrepreneurs claim to have come up with the best business driving strategies while talking to right customers. So while talking to the right customers means whatever you are selling, your customer should know about the customers, they want to think about. It has become a common practice to record customer feedback right after completing business with them. Some online stores even take it a step ahead and offer brief welcoming survey to new users in order to take note of their needs right at the start. That's also possible that maybe whatever they purchase, then ask them for the survey, or maybe in order to enter the particular store, you could be surveyed that what kind of items you like, and what are your hobbies, what type of the way you like the payment, maybe what type of the shipment you like, do you have any preferences, then automatically those kind of surveys and customer feedbacks could be taken in the start so that you can offer them on the customization base. You can market them, you can offer them a new or existing products which might match their preferences in advance. So that's also the strategy of having surveys and customer feedbacks, maybe in the start or maybe later on after they have done the business with you. Know your promoters. Once you have identified target audience for your online store, the next step is to look after promoters of your brand. So you know that to whom you are selling, and you know that who is your audience, but it is also important that who will be promoting your product from time to time. Customers cum promoters are basically advocates of your business that help popularize your brand via word of mouth. Maybe it has become general practice to leverage a satisfied user base and educate it to build a strong referral base. In this regard, most companies offer decent incentives to their promoters. So promoters may be considered as sales advisors or marketing managers, or maybe the agents. They go to different people and they offer, or possibly they sell the products of a company as a representatives, and they get a commission. And similar way, if you are you have an online store, then same like the affiliate program, you can use the referral program, the referral links, on the basis of commission and promote them for a business. So it is important that you should be able to know that who will be promoting your business. Stalk your competitors. follow your competitors. Stalk your competitors means follow your competitors. This is perhaps one of the most important details business need to take care of. Whatever you are selling, no matter whatever the products, how good you are doing, how good your products are, but until you touch the market, you know about your competitors, you cannot justify that you are doing the right. It's been a common practice among industry giants to keep track of their competitors and their strategies. So it's a very common thing that you should be able to know that who is your competitor and how you need to make the strategy. In fact, this practice has been seen in everyday life. Take the claim to wash away 100% viruses from your hands. In response, another computer printer launched an improved hand sanitizer that does the same in less time. Similarly, online businesses need to be aware of products and services being used by their competitors. So is that true that the information of the competitors is must?
Yes.
Yeah. Because if you won't know, if you would not constantly know the competitors, then you will be in a big loss. Possibly, if you, for example, if you were selling your product initially at a very good profit, and because the first seller in the market and the other marketer, other seller came in and they are selling at the very low profit, and you won't know that what's the reason of the reduction in the sale. So the constant competitor search is important. Next is implementing an e-commerce application design against a given client brief. So obviously you have a plan, you have decided to create an online store, and you need to consider few more things. E-commerce web design is about making the journey to the checkout as quick as easy possible. Here are some tips to build e-commerce websites customers will love. First is, let customers refine their options. When customers are trying to search for what they want on your e-commerce site, being able to filter their options will save them a lot of time and effort. So now, if you are ready to provide the e-commerce solution, then you should consider that your site should provide the customers an option to filter, sort out any of the products, whatever you are selling. It should, your site should have a capability to filter the products accordingly. This is particularly important when it comes to sizing for items such as clothes. So maybe whatever the items, for example, if you are selling the clothes on your online store, then you can have the various sizes. It is important that your website should give them a sorted form of the sizes of the clothes. Sometimes customers hate finding that perfect piece of clothing only to discover you don't carry it in their size. What happens if you are not able to provide the filter and a customer was really interested? They tried to place an order, and at the final, they found that that particular cloth is not available in that particular size. So if the filtration will not be available in your site, then customers would be unhappy because of these kind of problems. Let them reserve their choices too. When a user starts to a narrow their navigation inside a particular category. For example, selecting large clothes only, they may make a mistake or change their minds. So it's vital that you allow them to remove those navigation selections rather than forcing use of back button clicks, which are repetitive at best and may cut off their browser connection at worst. So let them reserve their choices. Reserve their choices is basically related with the browsing capability. No matter whatever their choices are, they are looking for, possibly they could switch between the sizes and they should be able to select in maybe one or two of them. It shouldn't be the case that if a customer was browsing on the large size and they possibly tried to consider medium size as well. So it shouldn't be the case that your website should entirely may change the existing options and they might gone away. For example, the searching habit. If you were searching previously, let's say a large size, then it should be, then sometime normally on the website, they show you that items viewed. So let them reverse their choices too. So sorry, it's the reverse, not the reserve. Yeah. So reverse in a sense that you should be able to provide them the facility to traverse between. And obviously, it gives a kind of the option to them that their search history visible to them. Is that true or not?
True.
Yeah? Yeah. So, that the option of providing a reverse means it should not be always the case that they should click a back button from the browser, but they should have capability to traverse, to travel in between the sizes or the tiles, and you know, they shouldn't be able to lose the connection at all. Yeah.
Yeah.
Next is many of us don't realize how often the search bar on an e-commerce website is used. When customer comes to a site looking for something particular, if it's not clearly identifying a landing page, then most common reason is to search for it. So for example, on a landing page, on a main page, if you can't find a particular category of a product, and it is much more helpful that you provide them a search box and a button so that they should be able to search easily. Consider making a search bar the key focus of your website, e-commerce site. This will also work to keep users on the site as they may be tempted to look around more. So maybe using the search engine, your customers will be searching more and more. It will be, even if they don't know that whether you sell particular thing or not, but the search box will help them to search anything randomly and possibly they can get more. Fourth, if items are out of stock, make it clear. For SEO purposes, it is better to keep the product on the site instead of removing it and having to add it again. If a product is out of stock, that needs to be clear. So there are two benefits. If any of your item is out of stock, then your website should show it clearly that it is out of stock. Maybe you can mention that when it will come again in the stock. And also from the search engine point of view, instead you remove the item which is out of stock, you should keep it, and the search engine will still take to the customers to your website and to your product and it will be long lasting for the future. Whenever you will have the stock, and then you will have more customers. You might have observed that most of the discontinued items, when you search on the internet, then the Google, it still takes you to the vendors who used to sell particular items or models, but they mention that it is out of stock. So it is a good technique that they really don't, they mention out of stock. So is that a good idea?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. And normally, I have observed that even the obsolete, the discontinued items, they is still put on the websites and by mentioning out of stock. And what happens, we willingly or unwillingly go to their website and they give the suggestions to alternatives. Is it true?
True.
Yeah, that's a really very good marketing tip, isn't it?
Yeah.
The fifth one, use of quality photographs. That's true, that e-commerce is all about buying with your eyes, as most of the time you won't get to see or touch the real thing until it has been delivered. Having plenty of photos is a guaranteed way to attract more business, so plan a product page layout in mind. Will you have a product slide show or tile thumbnails? Just as important is the quality of these images, as blurry or pixelated photos will be a major put off as well as bringing down the quality of the site. That's true, that the more pictures of your product about the descriptions you will have more number of customers and successful customers. Otherwise you will lose the customers because of the poor product picturization. Make the shopping cart visible. How? On every page. More advanced online shoppers will not want to be sent straight to the basket page if they add an item. Therefore it is important that a basket is visible on every page of the site. That's true. Many designers like to use the sidebar for this, but mostly they use promotions on the sidebar. A basket must also contain more information than simply how many items are in it. Consider using thumbnails of the products to add a bit of life to the basket. So if you have a page, whatever the items you have put in the basket, they should be visible on the top or maybe on the sidebar. The total quantity and small pictures like thumbnail should be visible to the customers all the time is basically advisable, so that they should know that what they have purchased and what they need to purchase. Sometimes people have a list of items to purchase from the same website. They don't remember that how many of them they have placed into the basket. And that happens really with me as well. Sometimes we add one or two items, the same item one more time, because we can't see the basket all the time. If we are doing a purchasing into a real shop, then we can easily see a basket is that you, for example, you put the sugar in a basket and you will not be visiting or putting the sugar again, the pack of sugar. However, the e-com site, the basket, the shopping cart should be visible on every page. So it is advisable that make a shopping cart visible on every page. Make your site easy to navigate. It's simple. For larger site, there is a good chance that there will be a lot of categories. So traversing between the pages, you need to provide their drop-down menus so that you should be able to navigate to your site easily and more frequently. Like a top down menus will help you to go to your account details or orders or the maybe the shopping cart very quickly. Don't add delivery charges at the end. So it is advisable that whatever you are selling, and do not give the information about the delivery charges at the end. Customers dislike, and most of the time they don't buy the items at all, because it's a kind of marketing strategy. Sometimes you offer the product at a cheaper price, and as compared to the your competitors, it is only because if you don't include the delivery charges. So it is advisable that you may mention the delivery cost as well, but it's a marketing strategy. For example, a very small item like a computer mouse, the same brand you are selling for example, if someone is selling the same brand of the mouse, let's say a computer mouse for £3 including delivery, and you are selling the same mouse for £1, the customer will come to you quickly, and what they will notice that you will be applying maybe £2 more or maybe £2.50, but they will not like. Is it true?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so it is advisable that don't add the delivery charges at the end. It is a kind of negative impression. Yeah.
Yeah.
SEO is search engine optimization, is something which is mostly underestimated on e-commerce website design projects. Without a well optimized site, the only way you will have to attract your visitors is via pay per click. So SEO, search engine optimization, is basically a big thing. It's not a common thing, and it is always underestimated that you will be successfully optimizing the search engine, but that's not true, because it's not an easy task. If you expect that by providing certain few steps of SEO, you will your website will be up in the search engine, that's not always true. You need to work hard. Otherwise, you might need to advertise your website on the basis of pay-per-click or Google AdWords or different many advertising sources. So considering SEO in a well manner is advisable. Evaluating an e-commerce model. An analytical evaluation framework is presented based on the concept of both demand and supply side, economies of scale and scope, as well as the theories of transaction cost and switching cost. However, there is no single dominant effect or cost advantage model that will provide a long-term sustainable competitive advantage for a company. But without understanding of the underlying strategic logic of a digital economy, companies will not be able to take full advantage of disruptive power of e-commerce. How would you evaluate the your model is good, working well? It is not, there is no any particular strategy that your model of e-commerce is working well. It really depends what demand and how you are supplying and how the scale and scope of your transactions going. If you are doing well, it means your model is working well. If you are not doing well, it means you need to consider the model at every stage and need to improve it. And that is basically the strategy that whichever is successful, giving you more business, is the good model. Evaluating e-com application solution itself. Selling and buying is an essential part of everyday life. That's true. Its existing is as old as human in the different formats. Yeah. Selling and buying is very old thing. After entering into the internet world, where people choose everything online. E-commerce is advertised as one of the most feasible online business on the web today. So how you can evaluate? Let us see. E-commerce application development is closely associated to the integration of special software to assist business management and web page control. End-to-end commerce application development is nothing more than a business strategies that are aimed at boosting business. Yeah, that is why those involved in B2B dealings have been experiencing an increased demand for e-commerce application development. All types of solutions are presently available online, helping people develop their businesses in the most profitable way possible with least investment and little effort. So whatever the solution you have, if it is helping people and develop their businesses more profitable, more and more profitable with least investment and least efforts, then it is successful and the evaluation of the solution is good, and then the business grows more and more. Evaluating e-commerce application use. User reviews are very helpful for e-commerce websites. More than 60% users, according to statistics, base their decision to use particular e-commerce website on customer reviews. So how you will be evaluating the application use, e-com application use, based on customer reviews. So if you have a good reviews about the website, then you have a good business. Says about more than 60% users, according to the statistics, they make their decisions depending on the customer reviews. Other benefits of having customer reviews on e-commerce websites are higher conversion rates, strengthened customer trust, optimized SEO, increasing sales, and engaged customers. Many e-commerce businesses implement user reviews to gain bigger revenue. So not only the customer reviews, they help in the decision making of the new customers for their purchase, but they are being converted, the conversion rate for becoming the successful customers, and also creating or strengthening the trust of customers. Basically, the reviews increase the trust of a customer by looking at the review. They help to optimize SEO, because search engine optimization involves the reviews of the website as well. They increase sales and engagement of the customers as well. For example, there is a product and people talk about the product, they talk in a positive way, then you will definitely buy it. If you do not have any of the review available about a product, then obviously you will be thinking whether you should buy or not. So the reviews help you a lot to make your customer base, to strengthen the trust of the customer. So it is advisable to have the customer reviews integrated on your website. Become trustful by yourself. Researchers revealed very interesting statistics. Apparently, people trust 12 times more to user reviews than a description on e-commerce website. Other study shows that 30% of visitors think that reviews are fake if they cannot find negative reviews. Placing user reviews with positive and negative views mixed up can persuade people to trust your e-commerce more. Is that true?
Very true.
Yeah. So becoming a trustful is important. Only positive views will not help. You should be able to provide the negative views as well. And also, the description of your item makes more sense as compared to the review. For example, if your website is saying that this product is warranted for, let's say, 3 years, and up to 99% people have not claimed the warranty, it means the quality of the product is really of high standard. The whatever the description you are giving, it says that 12 times more effective than the reviews. That's true. If you have presented your product very well, you haven't left any question being answered on the site. For example, you have mentioned all the questions and answers about your website, then it is more helpful as compared to the random reviews by the users. Yeah. Increase sales. As in the sphere of commerce, e-commerce business is not an exception. Its main goal is to drive a revenue to user reviews and testimonials drive sales up to 18%. Besides, customers who read user reviews and frequently ask questions are 100% more likely to buy something while visiting websites. Total amount which they spend is 11% more than total amount spent by users who don't read reviews and frequently ask questions. By updating reviews, you can engage more visitors and increase number of sales. So overall, how you can increase the sales? You need to keep your website up to date. How? It says that testimonials drive sales up to 18%. So if you are including the testimonials of the users, then they can increase up to 18%. And the customers who read the reviews while frequently asked questions are 100% more likely to buy something while visiting website. So the frequently asked questions have also a worth to include. Like in the previous slide, you should consider all aspects, reviews, frequently asked questions, and everything, so that you can increase the sales. SEO and user generated content. You cannot become a successful in the internet without correct SEO. User generated content such as user reviews will attract crawling search engines to your website, Google, Bing, Yahoo, etc. Fresh and relevant content which users will post on your website is just what search engines prefer. How? It is advisable that your SEO should have some user-generated content. It shouldn't have the same similar technical knowledge, whatever you have and whatever the technical knowledge the other websites have. Possibly you should have some distinct information about the product, about the summary, a different kind of the reviews, and different content, a user content, a user generated content. It is much more helpful for you. Otherwise, search engine optimization will not be that much effective. Now, the deployment of e-commerce solution. Here are a few other aspects of e-commerce site that developers will want to be sure to consider during the development process. Responsive design. The use of mobile devices to access the website is continually growing, and e-commerce sales are a large portion of this traffic. So is that the use of mobile is increasing as compared to the normal websites?
Yes, going to the shop is busy. Okay.
Yeah. So In fact, statistics show that by let's say by 2007, by the end of 2007 or maybe in coming few years, over 1/4 of e-commerce sales will be made via mobile. That's a prediction that 1/4, maybe currently people are not using that much mobile for purchasing the items, but there is an expectation that everybody will be using their mobile not only for entertainment and other uses, but the all purchases will be carried out via mobile. And maybe not 1/4, maybe the 50% of the people may switch to the mobile purchases. That's true, because we have now reduced the usage of our laptops and desktops. Now everything we can do on the mobiles, and little bit sometimes we try to consider some transactions or purchases on the computer, but as soon as the responsive designs will be available on the internet, on the mobile, and the customers will be comfortable, then this ratio will be increased much and increased more as expected. Support guest checkouts. Guest checkout is basically the what happens, the most of the time you need to create your account and you need to provide your much of the details in order to create your account. But what happens, like PayPal account, if you have a gateway, payment gateway, and probably you already have your delivery details in your PayPal, then your website should be able to take the customer shipping addresses from the payment processor and deliver to the customer directly without asking the customer to the account, and in order to save the time of the customer. And possibly, instead of creating the account first and then asking the customer to place an order, possibly with the minimal information, like the information taken from their payment processors, should also be advantageous. So support as a guest checkout is basically helpful and advisable. Site search is important. Statistics show that 30% of visitors to e-commerce sites use search to find the products they are looking for. So it is important to make sure the search functionality is available and easy to use. In addition, it's a good idea to utilize features like autocomplete to help users find popular products or items related to their searches. So the search autocomplete as well. Are you clear what is autocomplete? Do you know what is autocomplete?
All right.
Are you clear the how autocomplete works?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. So what happens, for example, if you are typing a word, you wrote two characters, and rest of the search, like on the eBay, you will be getting very quickly. Yeah, and you will get a list of available options, isn't it?
Yeah.
Security is essential. So as we discussed previously, that your website should definitely be secure by providing the SSL certificate that will be encrypting the all information, and you will be safe enough from any kind of fraud that can happen on your on the customer credentials or whatever the credit card information is. Integration with legacy systems. For example, if you created a website and possibly your store is already the inventory of your store is already carried out in a computerized software, so that it is advisable that your solution should have capability to integrate with legacy systems. Legacy systems are the old systems. So your development, your solution should be able to communicate with the old inventory control system. Whatever you have, it shouldn't have any problem for integrating your online business with the offline business. So is it possible that the legacy system problems can happen?
Yeah, it's just a bit. Whoa.
Yeah. So even not only the legacy systems, but your solution should be flexible enough to run on the any kind of browser, any kind of mobile application, or any of the integration related or communication is required. It should be able to deal very well, and there shouldn't be any compatibility issues. Yeah. Then the maintenance and support of e-commerce applications. The maintenance and support services includes product listing and addition and deletion. So it comes under the maintenance that you should be able, your solution should be able to list, add, delete, graphic design and image optimization from time to time. Your graphics should be optimized. Your images should be optimized. Banner creation for new arrivals, new launches and discounts. That should be, that they come under the maintenance. Content creation and content updating. That's kind of maintenance and support. On-site search engine optimization, e-commerce security management, security needs to be updated from time to time. Layout and coding changes, that comes under the maintenance and support services. Creating user-friendly features, increasing conversion rates. Conversion rates is basically the increasing, converting the your customers who are browsing the site and converting them into the customers. Converting a visitor into a customer. Website traffic and analytics and reporting, deals and offers management. Now, catering for multiple platforms and different users. E-commerce is created for all kind of users. The development is done for all kind of users. The models help the developer how to develop the e-commerce site for all kind of users. When it comes to a platform, e-commerce development is a platform independent. Means it should run on all kind of platforms, no matter what user is using. The development should be responsive so that many users will be engaged with your site. So platform, multiple platform and different users is basically the, let's say that you as a user, you are using Windows, you should be able to access your website on the Windows, you should be able to access your website on the Linux or any operating system, as well as different user. User is basically that are you using the e-commerce site on the web browser, or if you are accessing your web the website on the Internet Explorer, are you accessing the website on the Firefox, are you accessing the website on the Google Chrome, are you accessing your website on the mobile browser, are you accessing the website on any kind of the browser. So they are basically users, and different operating systems like Android or whatever they are. So your solution should be catered for multiple platforms. That's it. So it was about the last learning outcome of the e-commerce applications. So do you have any question?
No questions.
Okay, good. So I believe that this particular unit was very lengthy enough, and but it was very interesting and gave a really good information and interesting information, whatever we discussed in all these learning outcomes, isn't it?
Yeah, most interesting.
Yeah, most interesting. And so we finish this, we end up this session today, and I will see you next week. Yeah.
All right, see you next week. Thank you.
Okay, see you. See you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. Bye.